Beihong, founding father. His works and influential methods changed Chinese art and culture forever. While his creations have appeared alongside other legends in Europe and Asia, the ravages of war kept his masterpieces from ever appearing in the United States dream. It may not have been possible had it not been for a special Denver connection and the story of a chance friendship that began in 1919. With Chinese brush painting, he saw some illustrated books depicting European paintings, and he became fascinated with what was being done in the West, and he was able to receive a... Arriving in Paris, Xu Beihong met a young and charismatic Chinese literary scholar and master at French language named Xie Shoukang.
Hotel or apartment complex where Xie Shoukang, Chinese, I was surprised that
they spent every day of their lives together and were brothers. Xu Beihong shared China, a refined master of sketch, ink, and oil painting. Although he spent 10 hours a day painting, he was restless and looking for something to stir his soul. He decided to found the Nanhua Fine Art Academy to teach new generations of artists.
The traditional way of Chinese art is that all students have to follow in their first and second years.
As war continued to ravage China, Xu Beihong was deeply touched by the spirit and suffering of the Chinese people. It is here that Xu Beihong focused the power of his craft. He paints the first ever monumental oil paintings with epic
trim thousands of years ago, and he's going on a mission that he knows will eventually lead to his death, and he is followed by 500 warriors that go with him, and it is Xu Beihong's method of showing something oil painting.
For years, he traveled much of the globe exhibiting his work. All of the proceeds from his exhibitions went to the Chinese people who were suffering from the war. A testament to Xu Beihong's influence, when the People's Republic of China was founded in 1949, Chairman Mao wrote a letter to Xu Beihong addressing him as a friend would, asking for a quote. Ultimately, Xu Beihong became the
first president of China's Central Academy of Fine Arts. Meanwhile, Xu Bei decided that it was a great actor's fetching as much as $10 million for a single painting. He created a new form of national art that still resonates in the work of contemporary Chinese artists today. Most of all, he gave artists courage in turbulent times
to capture the movement.